good day to you. I'll let you know how you can install Windows Server 2012 on your server. We need to start. I have already installed VMware vSphere 6.5 for demo purposes. I will let you know how you can install Windows Server 2012. You can install with the 2-3 methods. Either you need to boot from CD or you can go in HP utilities. You can install from there. Let's start. I will first reboot. Press F11 to restart. It's now going to restart the server. You need to now choose the your method. Either you need to choose boot menu or you need to go to intelligent provisioning and you can select from there. So it's up to you. Choose intelligent provisioning. So it's better and easy. I have chosen F10 intelligent provisioning. From there we will go for installation. Now opening intelligent provisioning. Be patient, it's loading and initializing network and different things. Here you go, configure and install for operating system. You can choose your required things. There are many options: current system profile, balanced system profiles, no change, system software update. Update before OS install. Let skip this update so it will not take any too much time. Configuration, array configuration, RAID configuration. We will keep current settings. Let's click continue. Select select OS family Microsoft Windows. You can also install Red Hat Linux and VMware vSphere. I will let you know in my other video how you will install VMware. We are going to install now Microsoft Windows. Source media, I have inserted disk. So let's see, it's checking and now it's loading. Operating system family, this one, and operating system it's found. You need to change now standard or data center or the other one is enterprise. So we will choose server standard, language English, US English, computer name. Let's see, I'll keep ABC new suppose, and password I will keep here. It's just a warning. It's last step that processing continue will install the selected operating system and will reset all drives to a freshly installed state. Data currently on this server will be lost. It means that I have installed already VMware. It will throw away, and the fresh operating system for Microsoft Windows Server 2012 will be installed. So we need to click on continue. Here it's going on, it's formatting. Driver copy. Now you need to wait a bit. I have a very good and high-end server. It will process very fast. Let's wait for operating system installation. You can see the progress. This is partition type and size. It's NTFS and it's almost 280 GB. Let it continue. We'll be back shortly. will take a bit. Let's continue. You just need to wait. It's very near to complete. I need to bit wait more. Just finalizing adding UEFI boot entry. You can see the progress of installation. The server is booting again. You can bring out your disk outside from server. Let's let it be restarted. It's restarting now. It's restarting after Windows Server 2012 installation. It's first time boot after installation of Windows Server 2012, so don't worry, it will take maybe a bit more time than usual because it's after installation's first boot. You now need to set up a Windows setup, accept and license Microsoft software license terms and click next, and it's showing that you will restart several times. it will continue. I'll be back when it's going to finish the setup. So it's booting after installations, getting device ready. It's now 100%. It's again restarting because it will restart in several ways and several times. Let's wait for its booting and then I'll be come back again. Here you go. You need to enter your product key, what you have received from Microsoft to activate this. You can skip as of now. I'm skipping. You have 3 days. Within 3 days you need to activate your newly installed Windows Server 2012. It's again restarting. Let's restart it. It will go automatically for restarting. Congratulations! Here you go. You have installed your Windows 2012 server on the machine. You have already installed VMware vSphere. Now you can perform your functions. It's restarting, as I told you, it will automatically restart. Let's after restarting I'll tell you what you need to do first. Okay, now everything installed. Now we will log in and we can perform. I will put password what I have kept. Here's your Windows Server 2012. This is your front end. You can add roles, features, other servers to manage, server group. It's having very good features and better than 2008. You can add your required roles for DHCP or it's up to you now. Thank you very much for seeing this video.